audience. Welcome back to the channel. It's Lauren. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're doing well. Today we're talking all about palettes. I wanted to sit here, talk about what I've been using, and basically update you guys on the palette project that I've been doing this year. I will link my initial kind of video that I did, I think at the end of January, down below so you can check that out. But it's gonna just be kind of chatty. I'm gonna talk about all the palettes that I used in the month of April. I'm gonna give you some of my thoughts and feelings. And really this entire project was just a way for me to track the palettes I'm using for the year, and that's it. So I'm not trying to like use stuff up. I'm not forcing myself to use every palette in my collection. It's really just me tracking what's actually happening because I have a massive and amazing palette collection. And so I really wanted to see like, what am I actually using? And I will say by tracking, there is this like extra incentive to use more things and try something maybe I normally don't. I'm learning from myself that I actually enjoy doing my makeup with like a different palette every day for the most part. Like sometimes I get hooked on a look or I have ones that are like my go-to fast ones, but that's been really interesting and fun to find out. I also really do love my single shadows and cream shadows right now. So I feel like palettes are fighting a little bit for the spotlight, but anyway, I think that's everything I want to talk about in the intro. Let's just get into the palettes that I'm using and we'll get into more thoughts. Oh, I also do have a mini little demo on this eye look. So, you know, if you want to stick around for that, I'll try to do timestamps that seem relevant in the description box. Okay. All right. So in no particular order, I'm not like tracking when I actually use these palettes or anything. Like I'm trying to keep it simple. Okay. Like my goodness, I really don't want this project to like overtake my life. I'm not about that. But I am like obviously invested in my makeup. So I do like the statistics and numbers, but anyway, these palettes are in no particular order. First, let's talk about this Charlotte Tilbury quad. I have had a lot of stuff come into my life more recently, probably toward the end of March and into April, and this is one of those items. A lot of the stuff in here are those items, and so I've had a lot of fun trying new things out. What is this? Okay, the Celestial Pearl Luxury Palette of Pearls Quad from Charlotte Tilbury. It came out for holiday, I believe, in 2021. I, at the time, was like, I don't need it, and it's so beautiful. The packaging is really quite stunning, and I really do like the exaggerized quad that I have. So I got sucked in. I got this and another palette we'll talk about in a second, and so far I have enjoyed this. This one's warmer than the exaggerized quad, so I feel like this one's really great actually for summer. That's more when I would want to wear this over when it actually came out, which I think is interesting. But definitely happy with that purchase and really happy with the eye looks. This is an example of like this kind of luxury small little quad that I can bring with me traveling or more on the go type of makeup. And I like to use this type of stuff for really quick looks when I don't want to get sidetracked by the millions of beautiful colors in my palettes and I just need to like get my makeup done and go. That's what I find these smaller palettes are really great for. Now the palette that I bought with that palette, because you know, I was like, let's go big or go home. I bought the Tom Ford quad. This is the Badass Lava Luster quad. And this is all shimmers, really beautiful colors in here. I definitely want to get more use out of this. I really only use this one time, and that's something we'll talk about in a little bit, but I really love the tones in here as well. I have just been feeling rosy, bronzy, reddish type of tones lately. I feel like that's also been quite popular on the market as well. So really happy with this one and happy with the look I did. I feel like these in texture, it's my first Tom Ford quad that I've ever got. And in texture, they're a little bit thicker, a little bit heavier than I expected. I know this is one of the formulas or like one of the quads that has been highly raved about. So that's the reason I picked this. I liked that it was all shimmer, but I know that there's a different formula than this shimmer out on the market from him too that I am interested in trying, but I'm gonna take your guys' advice and probably try to go to a CCO or find them more heavily discounted and see how I like that. There's like, I think one that's like wet dry, and that's something I think sounds intriguing and exciting. So that is the Lava Quad. I definitely use that this month. An older little mini, I'll talk about my small ones first maybe. This is the Lorac Mini Pro Palette in Mystic Oak. I really love this. This is such a beautiful, like neutrally cool leaning quad. There is this beautiful textured shimmer in here that I really enjoy using. And so I was so happy to bust this out. I loved the look that I did. This is such an easy go-to for me, and I'm glad I got a little bit of use out of it this month. Definitely just reminds me that I really like the Lorac formula, and I like these little minis. I think that these are totally underrated and don't get enough hype, but I hope that they continue putting some stuff out. I know they did the Fairy Tale palette at the end of last year, and I like that it's a slower release thing, don't get me wrong, but you know, I'm excited to see what else they have. This palette was probably the thing I used the absolute most this month, and that's because it's a duo. This is from Nars. I've had this on my like wish list to re-pick up. This is a repurchase, and this is the quad in Kalahari. I actually picked this up like back in the day, like years and years and years ago, 8 years ago. I can't believe they still sell this, honestly. but that was one of the reasons I also wanted to like get it in my hands, because I knew it'd be something I want, and I didn't want it to like, of course, get discontinued. It was on sale also on the Nars website, so it might be going that way. But this duo I initially bought because I was influenced by Fleur de Force, so it's been a while, and these tones of bronze are like especially my favorite. I know I just talked about rose tones. I'm like into everything. I just love makeup right now. Like, I really do. But these like purpley taupey bronzy tones where they're cool, but like also kind of warm. Like they're not actually super gray. I've just really loved, and that's what this is. I mean, there's two shades in here that almost look identical. They are not. They're not the same shade. One has a little bit more shine to it. One is a little bit more matte. I kind of feel like maybe the formula is a little bit different, but back in the day, you know, I got tired of this. It looks boring. And when I think about when I was transitioning to wanting more colorful shadows, I mean, this just wasn't going to stand up against sparkles and color, especially when that was what I was into. And so I got rid of it, and I brought it back, and it's beautiful. This is another one of those go-to easy types of looks. So I'm really happy to have it back. It's pretty interesting. They changed the packaging, and you can actually push out these shadows. So I don't know if they have like a single shadow situation where you could then take this and put different shadows in, but that would be pretty cool from Nars. I've really just been enjoying the Nars formula. Also, again, for like easy everyday type of looks. I feel like this segues perfect into this palette. So I also got the Summer Unrated palette. This was one I was on the fence on, and then during the VIB sale I just picked up. I've been using this a couple of times throughout the month, and I do really like it. Again, very warm, rosy. There's also some orange tones in here too, so it leans more that rosy warm toned palette than it does like rosy mauve purple, but definitely beautiful. And another palette that has me really actually looking out for more Nars stuff, especially the palettes that come out, because those do tend to be limited edition. And I feel like if there are different color stories or whatnot that I'm interested in, I do want to be aware of them in case I want them. I am still so sad I didn't get the Bijou palette, I think it is, that came out during holiday. Like, I wish I got that, but alas, I just won't let that happen again is what I'm gonna try to do. I think the next smallest palette that I have here, this is from Natasha Denona. This is the Cupid palette, and this came out in the BoxyCharm this month, I guess. I think it was like a BoxyCharm exclusive, but I'm also pretty sure that these have been repeats. I think that's the case. A Little Night Music here on YouTube, you should definitely go check out her channel. I think she made a video talking about that. I think I just saw the thumbnail, but I think that's where I got that information, just from the thumbnail. So I don't think any of these shades are new, but yeah, I got suckered in. I do like the packaging of these. You guys already know that, so I'm not completely sad about it. I do think that this is just a really romantic color story, and they've done a good job curating even the singles that already exist from Natasha Denona in here, but definitely something for me to be aware of. Like, girl, I'm not trying to buy duplicates, but I did. So I want to be more aware of that, but I do like the packaging as well. And like I said, these all can be popped out, and I do like to have my own custom 5-pan. So for packaging alone, I guess it works out, but yeah, just be aware of that with Natasha Denona palettes. The look I did with this, again, rosy, bronzy type of colors, really enjoyed actually these kind of darker mattes out here to help with deepening up a look. It was really beautiful. Maybe the next smallest, I guess that's what we're doing. I did pick up the two newer, I don't even know. They're palettes that did come out from ColourPop that were new for a day. These are from the Stone collection. So I have the Set in Stone palette, which actually all mine look different. I did a whole video, so check that out if you want to, but These with ColourPop are also removable, and I customize my palette. So this is kind of the rejects, or the ones that I didn't put into my custom palette that I have housed in the Set in Stone one. And then for the Twist of Slate, this is what my custom palette ended up looking like. Really nice and deep and dark. I have like a mix of cool tones and warm tones, half mattes, half shimmers, and I actually really have enjoyed this formula so far, and I like having this. This is in my like shop my stash for the month basically of stuff, and I really love these mattes in here for deepening things up and just kind of reaching in for that, even if I'm doing like a single shadow look or something, which I guess isn't a single shadow look if I'm using another shadow to deepen up, but you know what I mean, like a simple mostly one shadow look. Two shadow look. That's what we'll call it. Anyway, I am happy with these purchases. I definitely don't want to get sucked into all of the new ColourPop. I feel like that's just a world I can't keep up with, you know? I don't really want to keep up with anyway, but something about these yummy neutral tones really got me, and I am pretty happy with that purchase so far, and have been enjoying using them, especially with my curated palette. I got some more use this month out of the Cosette Crystal Cream palette. I picked this up in February. So this is one that kind of keeps coming back here and there, just like using a shadow, tapping it out on the eyes. So I did get some more use out of that this month. I'm realizing I should keep this a little bit faster, especially because again, a lot of these palettes are going to get really 1, 2, 3 uses out of me in a month. And that's pretty damn good. I think I used 14. Let me check my numbers. I don't have to think, I can tell you. I used 16 different palettes this month in one way or another. Maybe I dipped into a shadow, maybe I did my entire eye look with that palette, but 16 different palettes for the month of April are what I like used and dipped into. There's 30 days in the month. I also did makeup with single eyeshadows as well when I didn't even use palettes, and there were a few days I didn't even wear makeup. So for my collection, using something a couple of times really is a lot, like, you know, and that's what's interesting about keeping tallies, but we'll get into that more when we get into the thoughts. But this one is a newer one to my collection. I picked this up during a BoxyCharm sale. I had never tried the Viseart formula, and I thought there was no better time than the present to get this beautiful peachy warm bronze shadow. I'm really excited because the Viseart palettes also do the removable pans, so I'm really excited to potentially keep that in mind when new palettes come out, whatnot. This is the Minette Etendue. Oh my gosh, I'm so freaking sorry, y'all. But really quite beautiful. I'm really excited to explore more of this formula and this palette specifically, and excited to have a new brand to my collection. I mean, I had a bronzer, I guess, before that, but no eyeshadows. I've tried to continue to give the Hindesh palette some use and some love. I still wanna keep going, but I've kind of made my thoughts up. I'm gonna do a favorites and fails type of video soon, so. Spoiler. But yeah, this is the Hindesh Monochromance palette that got some use this month. A palette I was really excited that got a couple different uses in April is my custom Natasha Denona palette. This is the one I created when I also made like a rainbow palette with the more midi size shadow pans. But this is my custom color story that has these beautiful kind of grungy purpley tones with the greens as well. So there's a lot of things from the Trio Chrome palette in here. There's some stuff from the green brown palette, the blue purple palette, and I really loved this. I did a look also in a get ready with me using this. You can check that out if you want to see how those are. I know I don't have like looks with every single one of these, and honestly that's mostly because either I filmed in it and so it's out there on the channel and so kind of you've seen it, or it's a day I wasn't filming. And to be honest, one of the ways that I've been really finding joy in makeup is that I'm not constantly recording it for you guys, and I'm doing it for me, and I'm doing it for like daily life. And so maybe I'll get better at that. But also, my God, have you tried to take a photo of your makeup when you're just trying to snap a photo somewhere? Like, it looks bad. And I feel like the times I've tried to record it just quickly, you know, where it's not taking up a ton of time, y'all would not be inspired. You would not be inspired. You would be like, what's happening? It just never looks that good. I don't know how people do it. Maybe that's why I don't do anything on Instagram. I don't know. Okay, last few palettes here, and by few, I mean like 4. Okay, I have the Patrick Ta Major Dimension. This came out more recently, and I did do my look with this today. So this is the palette. You'll get a little like demo on if you want to see it. I figured it'd be nice, like in case you guys picked this one up, to have like an extra little look or something to see, at least on the channel. But yeah, that is another rosy tone. Another rosy tone palette. I swear I have my fill right now. We have the Sigma New Mod palette, and this is, can you guess what the tones are in here? This is a more mauve-y neutral rosy palette. This one leans a little more purple though, you know, a little more maybe neutral. I used this actually again last night, and I did this kind of purple shimmery look, and it was pretty. It went with my dress, which was nice. And so yeah, that's been getting some use. I rebusted out an older palette. This is another one in my Shop My Stash, and I think I just kind of dipped into some of the mattes. I think I was doing another look with a different shimmer on the lid and then use these mattes, and that was great. Again, not tons of use, but it was used, and I'm glad to be tracking because I would forget that. I would completely forget so many of the times that I dip into palettes here, there, or whatnot. And then when I think about how I think of my collection and like when I wanna maybe declutter, it's just not accurate maybe how many times I think I've used something or haven't. And so that's been another thing I've really enjoyed about tracking what actually is happening as the best I can. I feel like I've missed some things here and there. Again, I'm trying not to put too much pressure on the project, but yeah, it's definitely been eye-opening. So last palette, the side-by-side from Nabla, another one where I was digging into the mattes to create some looks. So those are all the palettes that I used in the month of April. Like I said, it should be 16. Hopefully I didn't miss anything. And I wanted to give you guys some thoughts and just some things that I've been thinking as I've been doing this project, which again, I've really enjoyed. I just have a spreadsheet where as I use a new palette, if I haven't entered it, it's all alphabetical by brand, essentially, like what, you know, the brand is what's going first. And so I'll add in a palette if I haven't used it yet. And then that's on this side, right? Like the palettes and the brand, so the brand name, the palette. And then on this axis, I don't know, I'm not the technical math girl here or the spreadsheet person, let me tell you. But on this side, I just have the month. And so then it's really simple. I literally just put essentially a tally mark. And then as I go up, I'll put two or three or whatever, however many times I'm using it. And I can see at least when I'm using it and what month I used it, but not the date. So that's been the easiest I feel like I could think to track it, where it wasn't going to take up too much of my time. And I wasn't logging information that didn't need to be there, that didn't really matter to me, and just took up again time. So that's how I track it, in case you were wondering. I wanted to talk a little bit of, a bit more on a recap of like what's going on for the year now that we've finished up April and I've updated you on that specific month. But in January, I used 20 different palettes, which I feel like there was a lot of steam in January. I'm surprised I used that many different palettes considering I got COVID in January. Like this year in general, this first 3-4 months has been a wild little roller coaster ride, Mr. Toad's wild ride. And so it's been a lot. And I'm surprised I used 20 different palettes, but I think kind of the fervor and excitement, of course, of the new year helped me do that. In February, I used 10 different palettes. In February, I believe I was also kind of sick still. And then in March, I used 9 different palettes, which in March I had my unexpected surgery. So that was part of it as well. And I feel like I've been able to really amp up in April, even though I was still kind of recovering at the beginning of the month, but my love for makeup has definitely come back. And I can see that kind of fluctuation of when I'm excited to do my makeup when I was maybe not as excited in the months of February and March. I just wasn't wearing as much makeup, especially if I wasn't filming. And so it's interesting to see the difference of that in the use, obviously, of just my palettes, and I'm assuming the other makeup items in my collection as well. So far for the year, I've used 53 different palettes, and I believe at one point I had like 140 something palettes in my collection. I've done some decluttering since then, like a few things, but I've also added stuff. So I'm not sure exactly where I am, but if we're looking at it in broad terms and rounding, I would say I've used about a third of my collection in about a third of the year. And that's been pretty interesting. I have no idea if I'll really use another third or if that will stay consistent through all the thirds, because I don't know if I'll actually rotate through every single palette that I have. Again, that's not really the point of the project for me, but we'll see what actually ends up happening. I think that will be interesting. And then last year, I want to give some thoughts that I've just been having. One, you guys already know, and I've been talking about this a lot, but damn, I am just excited about makeup right now. I've been enjoying doing my makeup every single day, and I'm just in that spirit right now. But I've also just been romanticizing myself and my makeup and my life. I think something I don't know, this is something I've been thinking about a little bit, but I think something that's kind of enticing about vlogs, which I've usually never been into vlogs, but I've been watching a few lately, and you know, it's kind of aspirational watching someone do stuff that maybe you want to do, or more like doing daily little things, like almost the minute things that they look so aesthetic and so pretty and romanticized essentially in the vlog. And I think it can make you feel like, well, why isn't my life like that? Or why isn't this like that? Or whatever. And so in the ways that I can, obviously it's not always attainable and blah, 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 we're not getting into that. I'm just saying, I'm trying to take the things that are attainable for me to do. And instead of like being like, wow, their life's so great, it's like, well, why don't I just do that in my life if it's possible? Like, well, why don't I just do my makeup every day? I could do that. Or one of the things I want to do is do some more of those body care elements that I don't normally do. So like, I'm not someone that's shaving my legs all the time, but I see other people do these vlogs and I'm like, oh, what, you know, or skincare sometimes with the mask. It's like this self-care indulgent moment for yourself. And when I watch other people do it, it seems so nice, but I never can be bothered. And I'm like, well, why don't you try to romanticize that part of your life? I don't know. Anyway, that might be weird. And I don't even know if I fully have all the ideas of that in my head, but that's just something that I think has helped with that. Anyway, okay. Next, another thought I've had is I do wish, like I think I've said, that I was tracking my single shadow use as well. Almost even my blushes, like I kind of do. I feel like that starts getting like a little bit out of hand. Like, do I want to commit to that? But it would be interesting for me to know kind of what blushes are really getting use, which blushes maybe aren't, and all of that. But maybe I'll try single eyeshadows either next year or at the halfway point of the year. I don't know, something like that. But that was something I kind of wish that I knew. And specifically with the single shadows, I think I want to know that because it's the thing that would take away from me using a palette in the first place, potentially anyway, because they're kind of fighting for my little eyelid space. Anyway, that's something. Next, this is something that I don't know how other YouTubers do it. I don't know if they just like literally apply like tons of makeup multiple times a day. And if that's happening, then they are getting so much more wear out of their makeup, or at least testing it and all that. But man, it's just like there's 30 days in the month, or at least the month of April. If you wear an eyeshadow palette every single day, that's still only 30 potential times. And so if I'm bringing in, let's say, 5 new palettes, I want to use 5 old palettes, plus I have single shadows. It's like all those things are really getting 1-2 uses. And that's like what's possible. I mean, that's jam-packed schedule right there, you know, back to back things coming in and out, you know, I'm not having tons of downtime or not things on my lids. And so that was just something interesting and also realistic for me to keep in mind, that that's the reality, that using a palette 1, 2, 3, 4 times for my collection is a lot of times. And that's hard for me because I'm like, but that's not that much. Like, you know, have you used every shadow in there? Have you tried all this? But that's the truth. And I don't know how much makeup you have. I don't know if you have a large collection, a more curated collection, a couple of palettes. I don't know. But that's just something that's the reality of my collection. And so, yeah, so I'm glad I'm using my palettes more and in this place of using makeup even more. But that's just the truth. Next kind of recappy thing I wanted to mention is that I really do love this project and I'm very happy that it is set up in a way that rewards me for using makeup and that I don't feel trapped into using specific things. I've also given myself a lot of permission to, like when I'm doing my Shop My Stash, to have those items ready to reach for. But again, I'm just excited to use any of my makeup. It doesn't have to be the exact palette. I don't have to keep making progress in this one shadow, digging in the same spot to show it. That isn't my goal. And I'm glad I've kind of like released myself from that. I just don't think for me, again, everyone's different. That might be exactly what you want and how you feel satisfied and love doing your makeup. So do your thing. But for me, I've realized where I'm at with makeup. I enjoy having the freedom to pick my stuff. And again, that I'm rewarded every single time I do that instead of feeling guilty that maybe at the beginning of the month or even a week ago, I picked a palette that I said I was going to use every single day for the week. And then when I don't do that because I'm like, don't tell me what to do, I'm going to do whatever I want. Or I want to use a blue shadow randomly today. Or, oh, I got this new palette. Or, oh, I want to do a throwback with this palette. Whatever it is, I am not feeling guilty guilty about basically like not following the arbitrary rules that I set up earlier. So still loving that. I definitely think that this is more, well, this is the most project-y I kind of want to get, but this has been a really great project in that sense. And I think that that's really worked out for me. And then last, I touched on this a little bit, but again, I'm really glad to know what I'm actually using. It's so interesting. When I was looking through the palettes that I've used out of the 53 for the year, one of the palettes I've used like 3 times this year was the Urban Decay Wired palette. And I would not have remembered that at all if I didn't have it tracked, you know? And so those little interesting moments where maybe I didn't do a full look, but I like reached in, dabbed in here, tried this, whatever. I'm really glad I've been tracking those to just see that, oh wow, I used that 3 times. You know, I've been doing this with my perfume as well. And that's another one. If I use something once for the month or maybe twice, but it's not one that I'm like obsessed with in that moment, it can be hard to remember that that's what's actually happening. And it's been great to actually see the numbers. I talked a little bit about this in my get ready with me, but I'm letting go a lot of like makeup guilt and using and whatever, all that stuff. And I feel like this positive tracking project has helped me to see that things are getting used, even if it's 1 or 2 times. And I think it's helping with that. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed hearing about my palettes and kind of a few summaries and just thoughts. I know a lot of you guys liked the video I did in January, and I know that this isn't a ton of updates or anything. I'm not doing it monthly, but I hope that you like this one. And I think we're just gonna get into the demo. So if you wanna see how I did that, definitely stay tuned and let's get into it. All right, guys, let's get started on the look. I'm gonna be using the Patrick Ta, the new palette, the Major Dimension 2. I just want that on my eyes. Like, that's what I want. Maybe I'll use some of the mattes, but I kind of wanna really focus on that sparkle and let that be the focus. So I'm gonna lay a base down. This is the Sigma eye base that I always use in sorbet. This is probably my favorite one for every day. I like the rosy color. Although it's like more colorful than you'd expect, it goes with like every look I could want to do. So it's probably my favorite one out of all the ones I own for more like a base situation. Anyway, I just blend that out with my finger and I'll blend it up pretty high. I don't let that like color or anything stop me from just going there with it. I'm really wanting to put this color on my lids without anything like on my base really. So I'm not gonna do my matte first if I even add mattes, but I am going to add my brow bone right now. I'm gonna be using this from Charlotte Tilbury, the new Pillow Talk Multi-Glow Highlighter in Romance Light. So I'm gonna be using that. I kind of dip into this side and I'm choosing to put that on my brow bone first so I don't have to worry about like blending away potentially any of the sparkle, because the shade I'm using has quite a bit of texture on it. And I feel like if I had to go in and, you know, really make sure that line between brow bone and lid shade is seamless, I'm probably gonna get some fallout and I'd like to avoid it. So I'm just putting this there first, and then as I'm tapping my shade on, it will blend up. I'm also gonna add this to my inner corner right now as well. And I felt like this rosy pink color in here really complemented everything, so that's why I chose it. So I'm just gonna take my finger, I'm taking that second shade, that's the one I want. It's a really beautiful like champagne-y pink, and I'm just gonna be tapping that over the base I laid down. So that's already a little bit tacky, not like a ton, but it has some tack to it. And I really like a lot of the time how these kinds of like dimensional shades can look when they're just tapped over almost bare skin, like not quite. Again, we put that base down, but sometimes I find a cream shadow acts more like regular eye skin, like as if you're applying it on virgin eye skin, as opposed to a shadow that's been like heavily mattified by matte powders, and you don't get that like kind of natural stick. You know what I mean? So sometimes shimmers look dull or they just aren't like staying there, that type of thing. I just wanted to stick it on, and I really like this sometimes over a glitter glue because I find glitter glues can really make the stick opaque. And so when you get these really beautiful textured, almost flaky, transparent almost shadows, they can just take on a different texture. It's not bad, it's just different when there's something even stickier than like the natural virgin skin. And so I don't always love that look. That's not usually what I'm going for. Hopefully any of that made sense. And I tap pretty high up, like especially here with the shimmer. Okay, I love it. I think it's so pretty. It was like what I was going for. It's a little pinker actually than I imagined it being, but I still find it really, really beautiful. I do want to tap so ever so slightly, a little bit of this shade. I might mix it with the cream, but what I'm gonna do, I'm taking a big fluffy brush. This one obviously needs a wash, but I'm just tapping them in, tapping it off, and then I just, another tap, I'm just tapping it on the outside. I'm not really doing windshield wiper motions. I'm not doing any of that because I'm not trying to disturb what's going on. I'm just trying to add a little bit, oh so tiny, amount of depth to that outer corner, again, without disturbing anything. And I'm choosing to do this last again because I wanted to have that fresh skin to put the shimmer shade on. And honestly, I didn't even know if I would do this. I didn't know if maybe I'd be fine with it, but I do want the tiniest bit of something going on in that outer corner. And I find just tapping, you know, building up slowly, especially if you're doing a lighter color, even darker ones I do this with as well, I can blend it out just fine without having to really swirl it around. For an eyeliner, I'm using this Charlotte Tilbury one. It's like the bronze shimmer one that she has. It almost needs to be sharpened, so hopefully it's enough for this look. And I just want to do it very lightly. This is quite a dry liner, and I think a lot of people would think that's bad, but I actually kind of like it. I don't know what's been going on. I feel like my eyes lately have just burned so much. I can't figure out. I mean, I already have dry eyes. The doctor told me that. But I feel like they just look red. They feel like they're burning so much. I've had to, like, I thought maybe it was the mascara I was using before, and I have noticed a little bit better. So I switched to the Stila one, but man, I don't know what's going on. So don't mind my slightly red eyes. Like, I feel like the solution is to put that kind of cream liner in my waterline, but I also know that, like, adding more shit to my eyes is, like, also not really the vibe and what I'm trying to do either. Like, I don't know how much that actually helps either. So I don't know what's going on. Well, guys, that's the look. I don't think I have mascara everywhere, fingers crossed, but super simple. I really love these. I mean, you guys know that already. I'm down for simple two shadow looks, like get out the door but still be beautiful or fun. You could do this type of look with any color combination, neutrals, colorful shades. I think the biggest thing is just making sure whatever you're putting on your lid maybe is a couple shades lighter than whatever your skin tone is, even if you're gonna go colorful or whatever. I think that can be really pretty. Or even if you're looking for something a little more sultry, about, like, in terms of depth, similar to your skin tone, if that makes sense. I hope you get what I'm trying to say. But I really love this. Super springy, super fun. I hope you enjoyed the quick little demo, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video and just sitting and talking about palettes with me. And like I've probably said a million times, I really have been enjoying this palette project and really just letting myself be excited about using my makeup and rotating through things and just kind of tracking that to really see what's getting used. It's just actually been fun, which has been great. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll probably keep you updated. I'm assuming it'll be probably another 3 months before I do a video kind of dedicated to the palette project that I'm doing. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Other than that, I will see you guys in my next video. I hope you're doing well. Bye.